Hello my friends. In today's video, we'll review the Marshmallow Test book. Walter Michel, the most famous analyst for the Marshmallow Test, wrote his first book at the age of 84. Marshmallow Test, Mastering Independent Shelves Fall 2014 became a second media fanfare. A part journal and a partial logical examination of Michel's work in self-control, the book peer-reviewed research on the Marshmallow Test, originally intended for him in college, and which has since been reproduced around the world. The Marshmallow Test can be a way to explore children's ability to delay pleasure and resist temptation. Children are placed in a room without anyone else and given a piece of marshmallow. One experiment shows that if a child pauses for a quarter of an hour, he or she will eat a total of 2 marshmallows. If not, they only get one. After the experimenter leaves the space, the child is seen through a one-way reflection or recording. The older the child prepares to join him, the more able to delay joy. Several recordings of children taking the marshmallow test are presented on YouTube, often indicating a diversion of the adaptive measures children use to deal with restrictions. The marshmallow test was so popular that the Wall Street Journal highlights it in evaluating US President Barack Obama's proposed spending plan. In his book, Michel examines the relationship of a test result at age 5 or 6 with social abilities and academic implementation in the future. Results show that children who want to stand longer for 2 marshmallows have better social abilities and better academic grades. The book offers some explanations for this marvel, including the possibility that marshmallows test of traits, such as deferred satisfaction, is linked to the creation of positive social competencies and impressive academic performance later on. For those looking for a step-by-step guide to help balance and achieve higher ratings, this might not be the right book. Michel talks about hypothetical ideas and summarizes the research. Despite the fact that it amalgamates many individual accounts to incorporate someone's touch, the book is not implied as a guide to personal growth. With basic and careful examination, Michel instead shows how genetic, environmental, and social components can affect balance. It emphasizes that self-control is not consistent or pervasive in all areas of a person's life. A person who exhibits a decent control arrangement in the academic world may struggle to demonstrate exactly the same degree of control while overcoming a drinking problem. To bring the materials closer to home, Michel often joins his difficulties in overcoming his illegal drug use and the way his exploration is regularly covered by his children's imaginations. Reinforcement is another important topic that the entire book talked about. In one area, Michel alluded to his time spent as a learner during his doctoral program in psychotherapy, explaining how his mentor, George Kelly, saw him work with a particularly troubled woman. The woman asked Dr. Kelly, "Am I destructive of myself?" He replied, "Okay, do you want? In this case." Michel conveys the primary purpose of the marshmallow test and the way in which future activity is predicted in how visual balance affects apparent self-control. This is an arrangement that Michel calls the engine of success. The idea is that there are major assets that maintain and grow your freedom of action. Michel illustrates this hypothesis through the example of George, a student who completed his 4-year undergraduate education with a full scholarship at Yale University. At the age of 9, George joined the same KIPP school, a school funded by the United States government. Michel explains how these schools try to coordinate self-control, mental health and delaying self-satisfaction in their educational program. It stresses the need for additional schools in this way. Thanks for watching. Hope you benefited from this video. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel and click on like.